And the bottom line here, Amy, is, I mean, lots of people were impacted by the pandemic. And if you drive around New York City, you can see small businesses, one after another, that have closed up shop. They had no chance of recovering because of all of the lockdowns that they implemented here. Do you think that this is fair?
No, not at all. And, you know, Bob brought up a good point. He said that they're going to have to prove that they lost their job. How are they going to prove that they lost their job if they don't have a social security number, most likely, or that they don't have a pay stub, most likely? They are illegal. American citizens should be the priority. We have millions of people who are still unemployed and trying to pick themselves off the ground financially, trying to get everything back in order. This is a slap in the face of our own people here in, America. And of course, would we like to help those who are less fortunate? Yes. But guess what? You're illegal. You still have to come through our country the correct way in order to be accepted into the unemployment program.
Yeah, it does seem like yet another example, Stacey, of people being rewarded above those that try to follow the law and try to do things legally.
Democrats only care about American citizens when it comes to increasing our taxes and telling us stuff we can't do, like you can't go outside without a mask, or you need a vaccine passport, or, you know, you have to get vaccinated regardless of your medical history or status as a COVID positive person in the past. They really want to increase our taxes and then defund our police and then give money to illegal aliens as a draw to bring more of them in. I actually interviewed Carol Markowitz about this, and she was discussing Park Slope, New York. It's a part of New York City that is so full of people who, you know, citizens. These are Americans. They live there, but they can't send their kids to the Park Slope school for kindergarten because the school is full. So they have to send their kids outside of their traditional district. But these are the same people, liberals. It's a liberal enclave, who are advocating for more illegal aliens to come in, and especially the children. So if we sent the illegal aliens to their neighborhood, Park Slope, when sent them to the place where they have the most support, then we'd have to ask, because you immediately see them backlash and say, no, we don't want those kids here because we don't even have enough room in our schools for ourselves, for our own kids. Then we would see them start to change their mind about this. But instead, they're dumping the illegal alien kids in small towns on the border, Arizona, California, and then they're shipping them into the interior of the country. So we're not seeing the people who advocate for this policy actually have to pay for it. So at least in this case, New Yorkers who are having their taxes increased because the budget is busted are also going to be the ones to experience the influx of illegal aliens coming to take advantage of this new program that Cuomo's putting out.
Yeah, and Cuomo is planning, what, $4.3 billion in tax hikes in what he's calling this pandemic shortfall, which, Bobby, you know, a lot of folks saying he caused a lot of this shortfall.
Right, right. And I love the lead into the program. It's like, what better way to take, you know, the focus off the scandals than to put something outrageous like $2 trillion for illegal aliens? I mean, that's a scandal buster right there. But it's just, I mean, folks, we've got to prioritize American citizens with these lockdowns that have been extended in blue states. I mean, I'm in Texas, you know, actually in Houston, just down from College Station. You know, we are opened up. People are getting back to work, but there are small businesses around the country that are suffering that may not regroup, may not come back. And for them to hear that, someone's going to get $15,000. And just like the open borders down at the southern border, this provides an incentive. Because like Amy said, if you don't have this paper trail, if you can't prove it, then anyone can come in and say, oh, by the way, I lost my job. You know, give me $15,000. How are you going to track this? And how are you going to pay for it? These cities are crumbling from mismanagement from the left. It's just getting worse. And like these liberal elite, they'll just keep doing it and doing it until everybody leaves. And then they might have to pay their own taxes to fund all of this.
Yeah. I continue to monitor this breaking news, Bob. Now that there is a Texas State Police are chasing two vehicles following this mass shooting in Bryan, Texas. At least one trooper has been shot by the fleeing suspect. So that story continues to develop. We'll have more right after this break. Stay with us.